much for that wonderful, warm welcoming as we celebrate a day of remembrance. I think we're all gathered here under the umbrella of love and compassion, which I believe are the two emotions, feelings, and virtues that carry us to this cause. Every Sunday in our church service, at my church, we start the service with a praise and prayer moment, where people come forward with their thank yous, their praises to the Lord for the good things that have happened, and their prayers for the things that they hope will. And it is worth celebrating some of the many successes that have occurred over the past few years due to your efforts, policy efforts from people like Senator Obhof and those of us who have been involved in the political process that were moved by your encouragement and your support to try to reduce the number of abortions in Ohio and across America. The first praise, which Senator Obhof alluded to, is the fact that we had a record low number of abortions in America this past year, the lowest number since 1975. That is worth praying. The rate of abortion continues to drop for women between the ages of 15 and 44. Last 6 years, 19 pro-life laws have been passed, and abortions have decreased by 25% in Ohio over that time during the past 5 years. All of that. We are thankful for the many efforts that have been made to improve public policy and that have led your efforts. Passionate voices, the determination to share a view of the world where we care about the lives of the unborn and try to make progress in our policies to be more compassionate towards both the mothers and the unborn children. But we also have much to pray for as we look ahead. I was in Washington over the weekend, both for the Friday inauguration and for the protests and the rallies that occurred on Saturday. And there was a lot of emotion, very divided country, very divided about what this nation should be going forward. And there were a lot of rallies and protests. And right in the middle of one, my wife and I walked in to the St. John's Church where the president and the vice president had prayed on Friday. We walked in there on Saturday. And we sat down and we prayed. Protesting is great. It's part of the American tradition. But so is prayer. And prayer can't change things. It can't change things. It changes hearts and minds. It changes hearts and minds. And I hope that we will pray that we continue to change hearts and minds to draw people toward the cause of compassion toward the unborn. I pray, I hope you will join me in praying, that the next Supreme Court justice or justices share a compassionate view of life and liberty. And that we pray for all of the children, born and unborn, that we may, as a society, care more about them, and that we may build stronger families to support them, and to help them become loving, caring Americans. Beth alluded to this, but this is a very personal, issue to me. I was adopted. My birth mother in 1967 faced a very difficult choice. She had already had a one-year-old and three-year-old sons when she lost her husband in Vietnam and later became pregnant with me. And was under a lot of pressure to make a different choice other than to give birth to me. And thankfully, I was blessed with the wonderful gift of life through her decision to have me, to offer me for adoption, for me to be adopted by two or the most loving parents a young child could ever want. And I share my story for a number of reasons. Mostly, hopefully, it will touch some people that are going through very difficult decisions like the one my birth mother went through. And that the young ladies, the ladies who are facing that choice, may understand what a great gift adoption can be. What a wonderful gift it was for me, and what a wonderful gift it can be to all. Because we are blessed to live in this nation where opportunity abounds. And we are a compassionate nation. And the more that we speak to those values of compassion and love, the greater our nation will become. This is a day to remember that, a day to celebrate that, and a day to be convicted toward moving our nation further in that direction. Thank you very much.